Hello students, I am Mrs. Divya Soni from Maa Karnataka Public School, Pendurathi. Today we are going to learn about Unit 3, Section 3, a beautiful poem named An Information Bureau. Do you know what is information? Information means the information or the thing that we are willing to get is known as the information. And from when we are getting it, The media or the medium that we are getting the information from is known as the bureau. So, from where we can get the information, right information, is known as the information bureau. Take for instance, if we are talking about CIP, what is the full form of CIP? Central Information Bureau. Okay, the central government which is exercising on the information about the country, about other things, okay. So, that department is known as the CIP. Okay. So, here what is meant by Information Bureau and what the poet is talking about here, the Information Bureau, about which condition the poet is talking about, let us see now. An information bureau right in our home you will find. To whom you can say the information bureau? To whom you go? Whenever you lose something, when you are willing to get something in the home, or whenever you are not able to find something, to whom you ask? Who is the first person you ask? Right, it is your mama. Okay, you go, every time you go to your mama. Mama, where is my pencil? Mama, where is my book? Where are my socks? Where is my handkerchief? For every little thing you go to your mama. So, here also the poet is telling you about the information bureau at your home. Even your father, whenever your father is moving to the office, he asks your mama, where is my lunchbox? Where is my tie? Where are my socks? Where is my shirt? Have you washed my shirt? Have you pressed my shirt? So, the main information bureau at your home or at any home is your mother. Okay. An information bureau right in our home you will find. Okay. So, the only information bureau that we can find in our home is whom? Is our mother. Of course, it is our mother. Each and every person, whether it is grandpa, whether it is your brother, whether it is your sister, whether it is your father or your grandfather, each one calls your mama for their doubt, for their misled things. Okay? So loving and so kind. Mama is known for its kindness. She is always kind to everyone. She is always loving. Okay, you love your mama? Yes, each and every person loves his or her mama. Okay, without mama, home is homeless and you cannot find your home like home. So, the information that we are talking about, the information bureau that we are talking about, in each family is the mother. Okay, for she is the only one we go to. Each time we go to mama. Even when we reach home after schools, we search for mama. Where is mama? Where is mama? When you come back from your place, from your games, you call your mama. Mama, bahut thak gaya hu, mujhe ek glass pani de dijiye. Do you ask like that? Mama, tomorrow is my birthday. I wish you prepare this thing for me. You ask your mama like that? Yes, we all. Because we think of our whole soul right on our mama. So, here also, because of our right, because of our love, we call each time to mama. Okay? For she is the one we go to, a question each one brings. For she is having the answer of each and everything. Because she puts the thing in the correct form. Okay, at the correct place, she put all the things at home. We are sure that she can where we left our things. We used to leave our shoes outside the home. We used to leave our socks another place. We used to keep our bag at another place without taking off our different bottles and water bottles. It is our mama that takes out our different bottles and wash it and keep it on the proper place. Okay, even she wash your clothes and iron it and keep it at the proper place for the next time or the next day when you have to move to school. So she is a person that knows, who knows each and everything that is kept in the home. Where is my hat? Who is asking that? That's father. Father is asking for his hat. He is not able to find his hat. And Jack mislaid a book. And Jack is not able to find his book. Father is not able to find his hat. And Jack is not able to find his book. Because they both have left their things at another place than the place it is meant for. Okay. I have lost my specs. Call the grandma. Grandma is not able to find her specs. Please, will you give me a look? She is asking mother, right? Please find my specs and give it to me. Okay, because without specs, grandma is not able to see anything. Okay? Where is my scarf? Ask sister. Sister is asking what? She is asking for her scarf. She is not able to find her scarf. Okay, I left it in the hall. She is telling that she has left the scarf in the hall. Is the hall the place to keep your scarf there? Is the living room the place to keep your scarf there? No. You have to keep your things in order. Okay. And then comes in the morning. Where is my new tennis ball? His younger brother is asking for his new tennis ball. He is not able to find his new tennis ball. Okay. Where are my gloves? Says grandpa. Grandpa is asking for his gloves. I need them right away. Even at the last moment, when you are moving, mama, I am not able to find my book. Mama, I am not able to find my pen. Where you have kept? She has not kept. But you ask in that manner only. Why? Because you know that your mother knows each and everything. She is aware of the things. She always keeps the things in order. Okay, that's why. Okay. I have lost my notebook, mother. I had it yesterday. Even you ask your notebook also. While studying, you keep it, leave it there itself where you were studying. And next morning you ask your mother that I am not able to find my book. I am not able to find my notebook. Okay. So, an information bureau. Yes, really that is so. She is the information bureau. Because you can find every answer to your question. Whatever question you ask, you can find answer to it. Okay. We always go to mother and mother seems to know. Because mother keeps your things in order, not only yours, but each and every member's things, she keeps the things in order at home. That's why you can find your home a nice place, an excellent place to live. If she doesn't keep the things in order, then it would create a mess. Okay, you will not be happy in your home. She always finds space for you, for your love, for your caring, and you should always be grateful to your mother. Okay, so this is a very nice poem. I must say it is a tribute to your mother, and you should try to keep your things in order rather than asking and harassing every time to your mother. Okay, thank you, students.